You were an MLS rookie in 1998, if I'm not mistaken.
That's correct, a long time ago.
So you have almost seen MLS the entire way through.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of things that have changed, but for you, what are some of the biggest changes that you've seen?
The biggest change that I've seen in just a short amount of time is when we launched this league in 1996, we had really no idea of what it was going to be. It was a foreign sport and an American culture. And so the beginning of that is we thought we had to take that and get Americans to love it, people that love the NFL. How we've changed is we now have an understanding that there's a soccer community in this country, and it's big. And there's 85 million people that are engaged in some way with our sport. So now we can authentically go out and try to build our soccer community with the Galaxy and with MLS to be able to grow the sport in this country. And it's working. I mean, the growth that we have had since 1996 is like no other league has ever seen.
And with the Galaxy being in Los Angeles, a soccer-rich community compared to other parts of the United States, how does that allow you guys to promote your club?
I think the biggest way is because we're able to attract some big-name players. So David Beckham comes to our team. Steven Gerrard comes to our team. And to be one of the flag bearers of our league, to be able to go out in one of the biggest media markets in our country, like Los Angeles, to be able to tell a different story, is a great responsibility. But to be honest, I mean, you look across, we're at 22 teams now. We have 12 cities that are vying to get in for the next round of expansion. So Atlanta just came out now. They're getting 50,000 fans a game. So it's not only localized in LA and New York and some of these different cities, but it's all across our country in the way that the sport is growing.
And you mentioned, you know, you were talking about Beckham, you were talking about designated players before. For you guys, signing a designated player, what goes into that process?
There's a lot that goes into the process. First, we couldn't do any of it without our owner, without Mr. Anschutz and his approval to spend money before we're even as established as some other leagues. David came in when it was the first of its kind. So for us, designated players take on more than just what they can do on the field. We want to get the best player, but they have to have some impact for us off the field. Giovani dos Santos is a great example. He's a player that came in the prime of his career, but he's also a Mexican star, plays in the Mexican national team. And with the demographics of our city, that comes into play when we look to sign a designated player.
Yeah, how has Giovani changed the demographic? You mentioned the demographics.
Yeah.
How has he changed the fans and just ignited the Los Angeles community?
It's been interesting. It was more powerful than we thought, and having him come in, it allowed us to authentically be able to speak to that section of our already existing fan base. But at the end of it, what we found is these players have to come in and they have to represent that, but they have to play well. Our fans want to see us win. And so he has done very well, and so we're starting to see a galvanizing of that group, and it's certainly something that we benefited from.